someone who like showed us the way, right? I see someone who's capitalizing on it right now the most, and I see someone who sees the way and is trying to go a whole different way to lead other people there. So I think that the point of this conversation today for a lot of people in this room is just to have a real talk with people and for you to understand like some of the pitfalls of this, some of our successes, and really just to get a better look at who they are. This is my first time ever even meeting Riot,
yeah.
But like, I'm a fan. I always support everything that's going on. Zay, when he told me he was flying out of Atlanta, I was kind of mad because I wanted to come and really meet your person then, but just as a student and as a fan of music, I can tell you, like, to my collective, when we started first using Fruity Loops, it was Zaytoven VSTs, it was the Lex Luger VSTs. Like, when you can have a sound that we wanted to emulate and we wanted to take to the next level, like, you are absolutely, like, you should be appreciated more, so we appreciate you, so we're doing that. But that's really the point of the conversation. I know a lot of people just showed up to kind of support us, but I wanted to really understand what we want to do, which is just an intimate, like, real conversation. So that's really what we're doing here today. We want people like it easy. My boy Julius, he's way more like analytical schedule to me, so Jules got real questions and things of that sort. I have some other questions, but you know, we just want to keep it flowing. And I think we have some online ability as well, too.
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying not to be analytical about it, because I'm very passionate about this and about you guys and everything you guys do. I think that just, I love seeing the evolution of music, and all of you guys are innovating it to be what music is today. And I thought that's so special to me, and me here in the presence. So I mean, in general, like, I feel like something that's synonymous with all of you guys is that you guys all, like, artists gravitate towards you guys specifically because you guys have a very unique take on music. So I didn't know if there was any, you know, of your favorite experiences building up an artist and what those would be specifically.
Wait,
what was the question again?
What's your favorite part about building up an artist?
I think being able to have a vision and seeing it come to life. And molding, you know, an artist to do something that I believe in, not comfortable with.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's it. Yeah.
Who has that art vision so far?
There's a lot.
It doesn't have to be an obvious answer.
Yeah, I feel like me, you know what I'm saying, like, definitely me, like, definitely bringing out, like, this like, comfort zone. Just having tried, you know, many different genres and stuff like that. I feel like we've had some success going on.
Me being your manager, I would say that. Appreciate it.
Oh, yeah. One more. I'm not gonna lie, I feel like she puts me though.
Great, what's wrong with
that? I feel like, you know, that you're what you call confine. And she got here, she was like, yo, like, I want my full part to keep. This death metal breakdown in the middle of it, and I was like, what? Explain that more, and then we like, what up? And she explained it more. I took the idea at home, and I made it. I did some folk guitar, and then I did this metal breakdown. And she's screaming in it, and it ended up working out, and it sounded crazy, like, because I had no idea where the music came from. It ended up coming out crazy. So,
now, right, I'm kind of new to you, but before high school, were you really heavy in like developing artists as well?
Nah, honestly, I just started making beats because, you know, when I was like 15, I was trying to record my own music, and I learned you had to buy the music. You know, buy the beat.
Yeah.
I didn't have no money to do it, so
okay.
I was like, fuck it, I'm learning how to make beats myself. Like,
okay.
I made shit for myself. You know, I didn't meet Ice till I got to college, so, you know, when I got her, like, I just seen something, heard something different, and I'm just like, you know, I believe in this. So that's when I started, you know, developing that. But, you know, I wasn't really out here looking to do that.
Yeah.
If anything, I was looking, you know, how can I make beats for myself and figure out what to do like that.
If you could, can you, like, I'm curious about, like, the process with, like, personally curious about?
I feel like in the beginning, you know, I was teaching how to record,
yes,
song structure, hook, verse, you know what I'm saying, how to approach certain records and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, fast forward now, 2 years later, she, you know, she found her own identity as an artist.
Yeah.
You know, and I feel like when you get to that point, you kind of let them do their thing. You know, if you have, you know, feelings in your heart, you know, express that. But, you know, you got to also trust your artist just as much as they trust you as a producer. So I feel like it got to be almost like even.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Or you listen out to them, what they like, and they listen to you. You know what I'm saying? So you kind of got to feel that. But in the beginning, I was more hands on. But now, you know, she blossomed into her own flower, her own artist, her own.
Does she let you produce? So like as producers, you know how I feel when I say that. Does she
yeah,
allow you
nah,
to produce?
I mean, there's some times where I'm like, you gotta do something. Like,
yeah.
You gotta do something. You know, yeah. She might, you know, be with it or not with it, but she always tries. And, you know, that's what I appreciate. She always trusts my vision. You know what I'm saying? I feel like probably if we were able to do what we do, because, you know, she trusts what I say, and I trust what she says too.
Zay, I probably sit with you forever, but like, I maybe want to understand your process, because like, I think a lot of people have better longevity and like relevance, and I know that comes from being open to change and being open to being fluid. So like, I think a lot of what gives us success in our era of developing artists, did you have that same path of like developing a lot of artists until you got to that successful person, or like, what was more of like your path? Yeah.
Well, you know, what got me into music, period, is me being a church musician. You know, I still play the organ at church.
A lot
yeah,
of my friends come from you, yes, yes.
So it's like, that's when my passion for music came from. And just like he was saying, I wanted to rap myself. I started, you know, making beats because I wanted to rap.
Yeah.
And my little brother wanted to rap. My cousin, you know, we just,
yeah,
but we doing it for the fun of it.
Yeah.
See, I don't know how old y'all are, but you know, I used to put my beats on a cassette tape.
Yeah,
I used to plug it up to like the radio, like the radio, and put the mic in and rap over the cassette tape.
Dub tape.
Yeah, dub tape. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you take that in school with your radio, and it's like, okay.
Yeah.
So many of those guys that at my school, you know, that rapping, I thought, okay, now he can rap for real. Come over to my house, in my room, on the make some beats, dub taping, we're gonna play this at school, and that's all we were doing it for. So, but I looked at that as developing artists, because now I'm making beats to tailor make how they wanna rap. So, my claim to fame is Gucci Man.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So, when I moved to Atlanta, I started working with Gucci, and Gucci's one just thorough street guy that just, you know, he's known for being a street guy more than being a rapper.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's something about somebody being authentic is what, to me, that just draws me to that artist.
Mm-hmm.
So me and him would just be, you know, he loved that I made beats and I had my own sound in the studio. And I love the fact that he was just street and he rapping about, you know, who the person is.
Yeah.
And I think it just went hand in hand. And before you know it, you know, we make a song just to put on CD and go to the club and perform. Not knowing like, this we gonna be a, you know,
yeah,
a big force of music.
I think for myself, you influence a generation of people that can't stand it. Like, in rap, you brought, like, I seen, like, real people I knew that never took an interest in the music, and they was like, you know, I need to learn melody, I need to. I think that's dope. Maybe, like, even a connected question of, like, so your background is, you're technically proficient in piano in church, right?
Or in church, and I'm not that great.
I was in Atlanta. I went to church with him.
Okay, then tell me, please.
That was like, I was texting my friends. I was like, I'm about to cry right now. That was a crazy experience. Cause I couldn't even put it in words, but like just like how everything is and how fluid it was. You just walked in and just started playing. Everybody just started knowing exactly what to do. And I feel like whatever you think, you might be like decently, if you're crazy, and that was an amazing experience.
And I feel like I have a certain gift. I have a certain set of tools. When I say I'm okay, that means there are so many musicians that I know that play me under the table.
Yeah.
Me. But that doesn't mean I don't have a unique gift. You know what I mean? So, and that was my thing at first when I first started making beats. I was playing too much piano. So they're like, what was you want me to do with me?
So, let's address that. As producers, sometimes we over the beats, right?
Well, I didn't know what else to do.
Okay.
I'm first making beats. All I know is I'm in church. So.
Yeah.
It sounds like church. Church for a street rapper, like, bro, I'm on that right there. You know,
yeah.
But that's why having an artist for a producer like me, the reason why I feel like I've stayed around for so long is because when I get with an artist, it helps develop a sound.
Yes.
You know what I mean? I think my sound is known more than I am. People just know, like, that's that sound, that's that trap sound.
And that's what it's going to be legendary ever.
Yeah,
it's a blessing, you know, to have it.
Yeah. So, kind of, and I think this is a great comparison to like what you're saying is kind of describing your background. So, Ryan, you're successful, but you're saying you don't have a heavy background, right? Like, you kind of pick up a
lead. I mean, like, my pops, you know, like the DJ.
Please, yes.
So, yeah. You know, growing up, I heard a whole bunch of music in the crib.
He was dancing?
I've been around a lot of music like that, but in terms of like musicians that you know, play music and participated in, you know, instruments and shit like that, I picked that up just on my ear. Like, and even to this day, like, you know, I don't, you know, if I have a MIDI in front of me, I can mess with it, you know, I trust my ear. That's what I got, the ear. That's what I'm gonna call it. Like,
that's,
I don't know how to play instruments fluently, but I got an ear, you know what I'm saying? So that's really my instrument right there, but I forgot what the original question
was. I think you answered it. That's maybe my next question is, so you everyone here is successful, right? Are you interested now in learning music maybe now? Or like now is it a thing that you want to improve? Because a lot of people get to success and be like, I'm cool.
No,
like, I figured it out.
Like, don't get it twisted. Like, when you know your music and you know how to play, your ideas like are transferred faster. Like, you feel like, when you hear this, it was like, people know how to play it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's ideal. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're worried about coming up fast, like trying to make another one fast or whatever you're trying to do. So I think it definitely helps. You know, I don't think it's the right way or the wrong way. It's just what works for you. You know what I'm saying?
Then I know, like, well, I know you a little well, but for the people in the room, like, what's your musical background? How did you get to the game?
I was classically trained in piano from like 9 to 16.
What does that mean? Is it like,
I just have this mean Italian teacher that will hit my hands if I just
need
my My dad was like, you are not good, I'm paying away from him for this. So,
you said 9 to 16?
Yeah, 9 to 16. Okay. In between that time, I was playing in like church as well. So that kind of time, I stayed out here and not be so classically.
Yeah.
You know, and in between that time, I taught myself to be so guitar and drums and high school with the drumming. The jazz band, the marching band, all that, and also growing up at that time as well, from, you know, growing up with my dad, doing the gospel singing, yeah, studio in the crib, so,
But no hip-hop?
No hip-hop. like, when I was listening back in the day, it was just, like, it was, like, bands like Creed, Disturbed, Blue Dolls. Whatever was on the radio, because we didn't have no like Wi-Fi or like internet or just like computer. It was like whatever was on the radio first or whatever I was learning in piano school. But yeah, my dad had a studio in the crib, and a lot of time I could really, you know, play the piano. I would help him produce his records, you know, so I was just, like, when he was off work on the weekend, me and him on Saturdays and Sundays, just making awesome music. And then, I learned some stuff today, y'all. I don't know about these records.
Go get them, man. You mean that we got music on the weekend?
Yeah, got music on the weekend. Me and my little brother James Green. It was strictly goth music. By the time I was in high school, we were locked up the studio on the weekend because he didn't trust us in the studio at all. So I was eager to just start doing my own thing. So there was a point in time where I was scared to the studio. And my dad would come home exactly at like 8:30 p.m. at night. So after school, I got off school at 3 p.m. This was like the ninth grade. I got off school at 3 p.m. So 2:45 p.m. I would be home at 3 p.m. And then I would go to the studio. It was
hallway.
It was not far. I would unlock the studio, take a mental note of like, what the studio looked like. I would synth pop or metal music or, you know, just do whatever like I was feeling that day. And I think that year to the point, we left the 12th grade. I asked my parents to leave my own MacBook. And I see this MacBook on Craigslist. It was like a broken MacBook, but the screen didn't work, but the computer part worked.
Right.
And I had this TV in my room that I could figure out that I could.
It'd be a lot.
So I begged my parents, we like grabbed it. I downloaded Logic, and then I started doing my own thing. I didn't even get into hip hop till like 2015. My older brother, he was a rapper, and he like came to the crib one day, so that I was making all these beats, this type of music, and he would basically coach me on how to make the hip hop. He would be like, "Let me just do this one," and I would play it, and he'd be like, "Do this beat." I would play it, and he would just build beats that way, and I just got more and more into hip hop. After I graduated high school, college, I started listening to more hip hop. So now I can try and do my own thing now.
Yeah.
And I was just catching up on the years of hip hop that I missed.
You definitely still do.
Yeah.
I play songs all the time. You're like, what's this?
Yeah, I'm sorry. that's what I'm using the burn on. Yeah.
Well, that's
and I feel like all of you guys grew up with some sort of musical background. Somebody was.
Well, there's definitely a lot of similarities, definitely between like the church playing back, because like a lot of Benny's music, you know, it's crazy how like you can really see it in his picture, like you signature sound that you guys are known for the path to get there, right? And it's like your dad was a DJ, so you know, you talk about feeling in your ear. You come with, first off, it's tough to make music in New York. Because every girl is something different.
Yeah. I feel like it's definitely more particular to have a sound. Especially when there's so much music right now, and everybody has a sound, and we're talking about this, like, who has a very specific sound. And the way that you have it, even take on your drill, I feel like it's just like some completely different realm. I've always been curious, like, how you're doing that form. Like, even listening to, like, three times a day, I don't know what music, but, like, even the, like lunch, for example. Like, it just is like it's like a breath of fresh air. So like, how did you get to that point where you're making music like that?
I think you just get to a point where you realize you need to, you know, bring something new to the table. Like, you know, I'm not saying I invented drill, you know, I didn't. But there's certain little things that you tweak, you know what I'm saying? Like lunch, like that beat's like 166, that's mad fast. You know, you try to rap in a beat like that, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of hard, like. Or, you know, Deadly, like, just having the boom, 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 boom.
Yeah,
like, you know, taking out that last you know, note right there. Like, little things that just give it that swag, like, you know what I'm saying? I feel like it's all about that swag. Like, you know, everybody here, like, say, they all got their little swag on it that you can tell is them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like, you know, hip hop, you know, it's always been here, it's always changing, but I feel like it's about how you take what you love and take it and kind of put your own little twist on it. You know, so that's what I'm really trying to do, like reinvent what I really like listening to, you know, and then I feel like eventually over time it becomes, you know, more of its own thing that future people look back and be like, oh, this is where this came from. But, you know.
Are you interested in taking your sound to other genres?
I mean, yeah, like I released Pretty Girl with Ice and Rema. Okay. So that was a cool little, you know, Afro beat. I had a little bit like a Jersey fusion in there, so you know I dabbled in that a little bit, but I have the most fun though when I just make rap records.
Yeah.
You know, like deli, like just like the deli, just like that gritty, like, you know, I told myself this year I'm just focusing on culture, like what's gonna get the people moving, what's gonna, like, I get the happiest when I see people physically moving or being happy to the music, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I think what I noticed that I like to watch this style is female rap, and that's the top, right? It's like we do a lot of magic sounds and tones and sounds, and it's tough to do only sounds that are aesthetically pleasing like that. Like, you have tones that are more feminine and masculine, and it's sitting the same thing. It's like, you know, you have the gangsters. You have like straight dance, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like,
that's the goal, like, you know,
powerful,
you know, like, you know, Ice is a woman, so, but, you know, I feel like you ask her too, you know, she wants music to be for everybody, you know, not for just one type of person, you know what I mean? I think it's for everybody to enjoy. That's my goal, you know what I'm saying? I want you to hear it on the radio, you hear it in the club, you hear it, you know, on your headphones. So, my whole goal is for it to be everywhere. But still to the street though, you know what I'm saying? That's the type of shit that I, you know.
Zay, like in your long career, have you ever thought about dabbling in other genres of like, or really just like musically expanding out, or have you? Am I just not familiar?
I've tried.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because
we did it by, like recently, like also just like funny, relatable story. Benny did this song for Nicki Minaj called Blessings, and we loved it, right? But then one day we looked on Billboard and we were number one gospel, and we were like, how? Right? And it was like, it was morally like a good thing, but then Bill was like, I wonder if the other people in gospel really not gonna like this. So it was like, it felt good. I was like, one time for God, one time. But it was just like, it was just interesting, right? It was like, kind of in 1 week we charted in rap, R&B, and country. And when I look at things like that, it makes me smile because I'm like, yo, like when producers really, like in 1 week when we really start going like multi-genre, so I was always just interested because like Philly's such a secular, I wouldn't even say secular sound, but like from like Atlanta, like you guys' sound is so like pronounced and strong. Like, did that ever make you feel like you couldn't go do? Cause like you come from church, so I know you like dance music, house music, and like did you ever feel like because of the area you were in, it never made you not really want to dive into that?
I think when I did try to dive into that, you know, I feel like as a producer, once you have a distinctive sound, it don't matter who's coming, they want that sound.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, I'm like, oh, God, let me play this. you know how you're in a room, they just like, yeah, okay, that's cool.
That's
can
cool.
You give me what you get?
Yes.
You know,
yes.
So in a way, it keeps you in the box, but I think at the same time, it's what's kept me around for so long and kept me as a producer that, okay, you know who me is. Because if you think about a rap artist, when I see rap artists probably fall off is when they start trying to do too much. They start trying to do something that's like, that's not them, they start losing their family.
Is there music right now that's exciting that makes you feel like, man, I want to produce again?
I always want to produce, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm a competitive guy, so like when I hear, you know, stuff that they produce, like new songs, new artists, new producers, it made me be like, okay, I got to already get in the studio and already get back in my bag. So.
Do you think it's naturally hard sometimes the different generations of producers to just naturally come together? Like, I know we like put it together here, right? But like, why doesn't this naturally, I mean, because we all are busy, like, why does this naturally not happen anymore? Of like, his different generations of producers being like less collaborative.
I think it's a respect thing. I feel like we respect what they do and they respect what we do. Mm-hmm. We don't have to just merge everything because like, we love what you do.
Would you be open to the merger?
I still do that. I collab too. I still do that. Yeah. I'm one of those guys that if you want to work with me, I want to work with you.
Right.
Yeah, but if you don't, but it's cool. Yeah. Like, it's cool. Yeah. You know what I mean?
It's like you're also hungry to find the next person. You're always posting and trying to find, and also it sounds like you're also hungry for people. So I feel like you're saying that like you were with Canada the other day. Like, I was like, that's how I think about that, you know? So, I think that even talking to the point about experimentation, like even for like me, like, I feel like if an artist is in a certain sound, and then the producer's like, yo, I think that we should go in this direction and start experimenting, I personally feel like that can add to the legacy, because you're expanding on something that they're usually not doing. It might not be like at first, but I feel like, I mean, has that shown success for you, like, in terms of experimenting?
Me?
Yeah.
I said earlier,
and you're like, yo, we should go this way.
Who do you feel like you're the most experimental with? Who let you really do your thing? Like, be like, go ahead, like, just paint the canvas. Cause that's different, right? Like sometimes we get in the studio with people and they'll just be like, what you want to do? Sometimes they have a very direct idea. Who lets you just go to watch?
I want to say me, but I feel like there's someone else that might be. I just can't think of it. You know what? I'm going to say Tizo.
Okay, that's a great answer.
I'm going to say Tizo. Because, like, Tizo's a producer too, as well, and a lot of songs like that we've done. He's like really hands on. He probably the hardest I've ever worked with. He always wants to set up. I love that.